Welcome to my channel Mumu's Art. Today I'm going to show you how to do fur rendering as well as making some silk trousers. So as usual, we need to start with the skin. Here I'm using a pro marker in satin color. Satin is something like a medium color, which is very fine working if you want to do a brunette or a fair skin both. It is very important that you start with the skin, because if you start drawing the garment, then accidentally you can carry some paint to your skin color, which is going to ruin everything. So here, first I'm applying a complete skin color. Then I'm using as a second layer, and I'm always not forgetting to put some extra color into chin. Here for the cheek, I use blush, and now I'm using a Copic with a brush tip so that I just make all the skin looks more three-dimensional. It's important that you do all the skin together, because otherwise there can be some differentiation between the skin colors. Here, when you draw fur, even with the drawing, you have to draw with the hair. And you have to pay attention about the direction of it. Hair is the animal hair. I mean, fur is the animal hair. So we have to treat it as if it is hair. So the direction is important and the coloring is important. Here I'm using a fake fur with long hair. As you see, about the direction of the marker I'm using, sometimes I'm coming from the body to the tip, sometimes from the tip to the body. So that it's going to look more realistic this way. And you have to remember that if there is something in front, you have to put a little shadow at the back. Like sleeves are a little bit different placement than the body. So you have to make it a little bit darker. And you can use the long tip, big tip, but still it's all about using the direction. And the hair is going to go with the gravity. So you cannot make all over like a frizzy ball. You have to put some hair just going down. Here I prefer to have some monochromatic colorway, which is always looking good as design. And even when there is some garment touching the fur, it's important that you give the hair. If you just make it flat, then everything will look meaningless. But you need to use the big tip so that you can blend it in a much better way. Here, for example, this part is totally, of course, straightforward because this is a normal fabric. But for the rest, I just use the hairline for the edges. In this pant, I'm planning to make something like either a viscose mixture or a silk mixture. They are very similar looking, and I need to blend it well, and everything is about the drapes. Silk or viscose, they are both soft materials, so the drapes should be soft. And the fabric itself should have a smooth surface. So, not just the composition, but about how much gram is that fabric or what type of a texture. These are also as important as the composition itself. Like silk is having a luster, but it is not too much shiny as long as it's plain weaving. If it is satin, it can be very shiny, but still Its luster is much more better than the polyester one. So, I'm using the same color to make everything much better. Here I'm using an amethyst color in Pro Marker. The other one was lavender. The fur part was lavender. If you are going to do anything with marker for the eyes, you have to put the tip in a very small way. If you want to have shine, leave a white spot along the bone in the shoes. Here I'm planning to make something like a gold type of, like honey gold. Because in gold, there are different variations. Some of them are greenish, some of them are darker. There is antique gold, there is shiny gold. So I'm planning to have something not metal, but most probably it is something like leather, but in gold color. But I'm planning to make it like a honey gold. And there are stitches, that's why I'm making it. In a composition, it's always important to use the colors in a harmonious way. So instead of making a totally different color for the hair, I prefer to use a very similar honey color. It's going to make the composition look much better because it's going to be like a variation of the piece that is in the garment. At this moment, it's very important that you sharpen your pencil, because here we are going to imitate the fur in the same direction manner that we used. But it is very important that you blend it very well and very fine. For this, you need a sharpened tip, because you cannot work with small details with a blunt edge. So, as you can see, I'm acting as if there is something midpoint. Because in fur, it's like hair. Like there are directions and they are not coming from everywhere. Generally, it's like parting your hair. You need to be patient at this moment and you need to make everything slowly, yet carefully. You need to feel it. You need to feel as if you are caressing that hair, as if you are wearing it. You need to feel the softness. To show the softness, the edges are the important one. If you want to do something like a frizzy look, it's not going to look like a soft fur at all. And then what is behind, what is in front, is also very important. You can also blend with your marker. It's going to help you to make it even more shinier, let's say. And one of the important things is when you start working for your illustration, you need to have a decent light and the background of your paper should be white so that you can understand the color differentiation much better. In the illustration, there are also some logical things, like if you make a color, both ends should have a similar width. If not, our very good computerized brain is going to say, no, it's not the same. There is something wrong. And we don't like this effect. So at least try to balance them. And you need to work slowly when you are rendering things like fur. If you get tired, make a break and then come back again. This way you can understand your problems, what you have done wrong, what you have done better, and you can correct them much better. So, illustrations are always taking time. The best illustrations you have seen, if it is not in a very sketchy atmosphere, is taking time. And in these illustrations, my aim is not to do totally artistic thing, but to show the garment. So I'm a designer and I'm doing it to show this item for somebody else than me and make them understand it and like it. There are other ways of illustration, which is more in the graphic sense, totally like art pieces. They are also, if you are able to do these, then you have to continue working on it. Because if you want to show some movement, some garment in very small lines, that requires lots of years of training so that you can make it less. Here, with the white pencil, with the white pen, if there are any mistakes, you can easily correct them. But very small amount is needed sometimes. So now, for example, I'm going to make the buckle to be understandable much more better with my 0.5 pencil. These pencils are very good because their color is not totally black. They are gray. And you can erase them. So, for the first stage, it's good to use them, but there will not be enough. You will be needing to use art liners as well. Whenever you make folds, you have to pay attention to gravity. And if you want to show any piece of garment to be a little bit more three-dimensional, like you can cast a shadow below them and around them, and with each layering, it's going to be more powerful. But if you try to do everything in a very fast way, it's not going to have this nice rendering touch at all. It's all about details. You have to put everything from top stitches to drapes. And here, why I put the drapes like this is because the knee is the power part. So, all the drapes are going in the direction of the knees. And blending with the colored pencils are very important. If you don't know how to use colored pencils, just watch my video about the colored pencils and learn about the techniques. Because colored pencils are an important paint group, which is very versatile, but not that easy. Because when you need to blend them, you need to have some training. You have to make it slowly. And there are multiple ways of doing it. But if you see them very sandy looking, that means you are not blending them in a good way. You have to use every direction to blend it, but it should be according to the object's shape. This part needs to be always darker than the rest of the hair. Why? Because it is beneath the ears. That means it is behind. So we have to underline what is beneath, what is in front. And the ends and the beginnings are very important in illustration. And now she looks much better. Layer by layer, you have to move. And for the small details, 0.1 art liner is good. You can also use 0.05. But the key point is to put art liner whenever it is necessary, not to everywhere you need to do it. So in some certain trainings, they are saying that you have to do all over. In my opinion, you have to use it like a shadow. For example, if you try to apply to a very lightweight color, then you can change the balance of that color. For this reason, I think it will be a good idea to use like a shadow so that you can keep it fresh. And you can use both very thin pencil, like 0.5 pencil and art liner together. You are going to feel much more secure and the end is going to be better. Because when you apply art liner, you are changing the whole balance. Because it is very black, then you need to blend it with the color that you make it around. Here I'm just applying a little bit darker color. So I'm every layer I'm evaluating and then I'm continuing. So I'm just moving it in this way. And you can still do some pencil, but don't overdo it. This is always the danger. I darkened it and now it is more three-dimensional. You can always blend the colored pencil, especially if it is an aquarelle, with your markers. And you will like the consequences. You need definition as well. For this reason, art liners, markers, colored pencils, all are very important. And the shadow and light concept is making everything more three-dimensional. Definition is one of the most important things on these type of illustrations. And here it is. Thank you very much for watching me.